Class, please click on got it. This meeting is being recorded. Can you please click on got it?
Yeah.
So again, a checking account is a debit card. This is money you spend every day. Understand that? Mm-hmm, a savings account is not connected to your debit card. Okay. A savings account is for retirement, new house, new car, whatever. Okay. A savings account, you save money for the future.
Mm-hmm.
So, class, one more time, please say checking account.
Checking account is connected
to your debit card.
To your debit card.
A savings account. You save money for the future.
You save money for the future.
Any questions?
No.
There's a third account, like credit, right?
Yeah, one moment. Okay. So this is my credit card. A credit card is money you borrow from the bank. Later, you must repay the bank. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay. So, class, for example, Andre spends $120 at Best Buy using his credit card. His credit card is with Discover Bank. C class, Discover Bank. Andre must later repay the credit card. A debit card is not the same as a credit card. So class, a debit card is your money. A credit card is the bank's money. Understand?
Yes.
Class, I don't know about Russia. I don't know about Brazil. I don't know about Saudi Arabia. In America, when you use a credit card, you must repay the credit card, because if you don't repay the credit card, you will have a very, very, very difficult time trying to buy a house or a car.
Okay. It's the same.
It's the same, right? That's what I would think. I know this sounds crazy. Some Americans don't care. They spend a lot of money using their credit card, and later they don't make the payment, or they lose their job or something like that. For example, I use my credit card for gas, for food. I'm not rich. I spend very little, and then I quickly repay the credit card. Do you understand what I'm saying? I don't go shopping every day and spend a lot.
Yeah.
Yes. Any questions about that?
No.
Class, not everyone will agree with me, and that's okay. For example, even if you're making a lot of money, I do not think you should buy an expensive car or an expensive house until you have enough money in your savings account.
Yes, I agree with you.
Because anything could happen. For example, Elizabeth makes $75,000 a year, 75,000. That's a lot of money. Elizabeth buys a new car, a new house. I don't think that's a good idea. Instead, I think Elizabeth should save money in her savings account. Later, she can buy a nice house and a nice car. Make sense?
Yes.
Yeah.
In Russia or in Saudi Arabia or in Brazil, do you have this problem or not really?
Yeah, we have some problem with this one.
In Russia, credit card not popular because people use more debit card. Credit card in Russia not profitably.
Because they have over 20%
interest.
Big percent
fee.
But every can make a credit card, but it doesn't give you all possibilities like a credit card in United States. Things if you will pay a lot of time for credit history. This is credit history in Russia is not so popular. It doesn't work like this, like here.
Okay, I see. Thank you for sharing. Okay, one moment. So class, this is my credit card account. You see, class, please say with me, total credit line.
Total credit line.
Okay, so class, if I want to, I can spend $11,000. Okay, if I want to, that's not a good idea. I should not do that. I'm saying if I want to, I can. You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Okay, see, right now I need to pay $37.62. Okay, that's my balance. So the bank does not have I do not have $11,000 with the bank. This is my spending limit. It's not a good idea to spend the entire money, okay? I spend very little and I quickly make the payment. I don't pay interest. Do you understand?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Any questions about this?
No.
I know it sounds crazy. Some Americans, they do spend $11,000 or more, and then later they stop making the payments. And as a result, they have a hard time buying a house or a car. When you go to buy a house, they check your credit history. If you have a bad credit history, they don't feel comfortable selling you the house. Does that make sense?
Yes.
It's the same with the car. Maybe Alexander wants a very nice brand new Toyota car. And the Toyota car is $35,000, only for example. And Alex doesn't have $35,000. He doesn't have it. He can go to the bank and get a loan for $35,000. However, the bank will look at his credit scores because it's possible later, Alex will not make the payments. Alex needs to have high credit scores so the bank knows he will always make the payments. Understand?
Yeah.
Any questions?
No.
Okay. Again, this is a checking account. This is a checking account. Class, please say with me, ATM machine.
ATM machine.
An ATM machine is an automatic teller machine. You can deposit money. You can take out money. Class, normally I do not use an ATM machine because when you use an ATM machine, sometimes there's a fee for taking out money. Like okay. It's a small penalty. Is it the same in your country?
Yes, the same.
Yeah, for example, Elizabeth needs money. Elizabeth can use an ATM machine to take out money, but there might be a small penalty or a small fee. For this reason, I never use ATM machines. I don't want to pay penalties.
But how you can get cash if you need the cash?
You can go to the bank. You can go to the bank in person.
And there's no fee in the bank?
No, there's no fee if you go in person. Okay. Also, for example, my checking account was with Bank of America. If I go to a Bank of America ATM machine and use my Bank of America ATM card, there's no fee. However, if I bank with Wells Fargo and I go to Bank of America to use the ATM machine, there is a fee. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
$1.50.
Yes, something like that. Yeah. Also, I don't really have the time to go to an ATM machine. So I normally use my credit card and I pay it immediately.
I have a question.
Sure, yeah.
Yeah, you pay for your credit card. You make transactions, you buy something and you need to pay in this day. How can you do it in your person? You pay in this day on the end of the month?
Normally, I pay at the end of the month, normally. Or sometimes I pay immediately on Friday. It's important to pay fast. If you don't pay fast, the bank will charge you interest.
If you if you buy something 28 March, you need to pay before April, yes?
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah, you need to pay fast or the bank will charge you interest. One moment. Class, say with me, 16.24%.
16.24%.
You see, it says zero. Yeah. This is because I immediately make the payment. I make the payment at the end of the month or maybe the end of the week, but I make the payment fast. If I don't make the payment fast, I will need to pay 16.24% interest. Do you understand? Any questions about this, please?
No.
Class, say with me, cash advances.
Cash advances.
Class, normally I never do this. It's possible. I'm saying it's possible. You can take cash out of your credit card. You can, but the interest rate is very high. If I want to, I can go to the ATM machine and take cash out of my credit card, but the interest rate is very high. You understand?
Yeah.
So I never do this. In your country, similar, right?
Yeah. With credit card and similar in Russia.
Okay. Simone, can you please read the first paragraph? Only the first paragraph, please.
Yes. I read it. Rosa is engaged to her boyfriend, Kylie.
Engaged.
Engaged. They plan to get married in May. And they are each saving $3,500 a month for the wedding. In the one moon.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Can you please say $350?
$350
a month.
A month
for the wedding.
For the wedding
and the honeymoon.
And the honeymoon.
Good. Class, so honeymoon is a vacation, a small or big vacation a husband and wife take after they get married. For example, I'm sorry for this example, Elizabeth and Alex get married, later they go on a honeymoon, they can go to maybe Russia, Tampa, Australia, wherever. A honeymoon's a small vacation, understand?
Yeah.
I mean, it's the same in your country when two people get married, right?
Yeah.
Class, are there any words you don't understand, please?
No.
Okay. Class, I need to explain. Do you understand the word joint checking account?
Yes, to open new account.
So there's two types of accounts, a joint account and an individual account. Joint is two people. Individual is one. For example, Elizabeth and Alex open a joint account. This means Elizabeth or Alex can put money in there or take out money. Normally, a boyfriend, girlfriend, or a husband, wife have a joint account.
Wow.
Do you
understand?
Yeah. What's better, personal or joint?
Okay, only in my opinion, I think a husband and wife should have a joint account. I'm saying in my opinion, it's a choice. When a boyfriend, girlfriend, or husband, wife talk about having kids, they can talk about, should we get an individual account or a joint account? Individual, that means it's only Elizabeth's money. An individual for Alex, it's only Alex's money. Make sense?
Yes.
But joint, it's together. Any questions?
No.
No.
Individual account. Okay. Simone is married. If she wants, she and her husband can open a joint checking account or a joint savings account. That means Simone can use the money or her husband. Also, class, for example, Simone's husband dies, all the money is Simone's. That's only an example, okay? Sergi, can you continue reading for me, please?
Okay, second paragraph.
Yeah, please.
Kyle wants to open a joint checking account in both of their names, but Rosa said no. She likes having her own bank accounts. She has a saving account and a checking account, and she doesn't want another account. Kyle is frugal with his money, and if she opens a bank account with him, he might ask her to explain why she withdrew money from the account.
All right, stop. Very good. Class, frugal. Kyle is frugal with money. Does anyone know what that means, frugal?
No.
Okay. Frugal means responsible, careful.
Okay.
Frugal is responsible, careful.
Mm-hmm.
It means you do not spend a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Withdrew, what is it?
Oh, withdrew means took out money. Withdrew is took out money. Yesterday, Ozma withdrew money from her checking account. It's past. Do you see the Zoom chat? You see the Zoom chat?
Yes.
Thank you for asking. Any other questions, please?
No.
Andre, can you continue? He might even.
Oh, okay. He might even ask her why she didn't deposit enough money into their account. Kyle thinks that Rosa doesn't trust him. He said they can't get married if she doesn't trust him.
Class, are there any words you don't understand?
No.
Just so you know, deposit is the opposite of withdraw. Deposit means you put money into the account. You save money. Mm-hmm. So deposit is the opposite of withdraw. Any questions?
No.
No.
So class, Kyle is Rosa's fiance. True or false?
True.
Good. No, true. Rosa has a checking account and a savings account. True or false?
True.
Checking. Yeah, true.
Good. Rosa has an ATM card. True or false?
Own a card.
Rosa has an ATM card. Is it true or false?
Maybe false.
False. Good.
False.
Frugal means thrifty. True or false?
What is thrifty?
Thrifty means that you know about all the latest styles. Like you're very up to date.
It's false.
False.
Yeah, frugal means in this situation, it means you're responsible with money. You don't spend a lot. Okay, when you withdraw money from a bank account, the balance goes up. Is that true or false? Yeah, no, false.
False.
It's true.
Any questions, class?
No.
One moment. So when you go to the bank, you can say, I would like to make a deposit. I would like to make a deposit. Or I want to make a deposit. So again, deposit means save money. The opposite, I would like to withdraw money, or I want to withdraw money. Okay. Class, please say with me, I would like to make a deposit.
I would like to make a deposit.
I would like to withdraw money.
I would like to withdraw money.
Very good. The past of deposit is deposited. Yesterday, Andre deposited $100 in his Bank of America checking account. Understand?
Yeah.
The opposite, one moment. Yesterday, Andre withdrew $50 from his Bank of America checking account. So class, with the past of withdraw is withdrew. Class, please say the past of deposit.
The past of deposit is deposited.
The past of withdraw is withdrew.
And what is withdrawal?
Oh,
it's a process.
It's the same thing. It's a noun. It's the same meaning. Okay. Now, so withdraw is the verb. Withdrawal is the noun.
Okay.
One moment. You see the Zoom chat?
Yes.
Class, any questions, please?
No.
Okay. And this is a lot of information. You can use your cell phone to take a picture of my computer screen if you want. One moment.
Google Career Certificates provide online training for in-demand jobs. Train for jobs in...
Okay.
Class, please ask me words you don't understand from the video. You can use the Zoom chat. Thank you.
Let's go to the bank.
Yeah.
Wait. Sit down, please. Here's the bank. Hey, Mrs. Martinez.
Hey, everybody. This is my bank. That is an ATM. ATM. ATM stands for Automated Teller Machine.
Class, please say automated teller machine. Please say with me.
Automated teller machine.
Class, normally I say automatic teller machine. Automatic, automated are the same.
Okay.
Hey, I want to get money from that ATM. You can't get any money out of the ATM, Isabel. First, you need to put money into the bank. Then, you can take out some money. That woman took out some of her money.
Oh, I get it.
They are tellers.
Class, please say tellers.
Tellers.
So the teller is a bank employee. Teller is the bank employee. Okay, so the teller tells you, oh, you have $500 in your checking account. You have $100 in your savings account. The teller is an employee of the bank. They tell you information. Understand?
Yes.
The teller can help you make a deposit or make a withdrawal.
Okay.
Tellers. They are customers. Customers.
Hi, may I help you?
Yes. I am Mrs. Martinez, and these are my students.
Hi. My name is Miss Lee. I'm the branch manager.
Hi, hey. Ms. Lee.
Ms. Lee, we are here to learn about the bank.
Okay, I'm going to explain it to you. When you put your money in a bank, you have a bank account. Bank account. There are two kinds of bank accounts. Checking account, and savings account.
Class, please say checking account. Any questions?
No.
How is a savings account different than a checking account?
A checking account is for the money you are going to use now. or soon. It is for paying bills or buying food. A savings account is for the money that you are not going to use for a long time.
When the school gives me my money every month, I put it in my checking account. I move a little bit of that into my savings account each month.
This is a checkbook. Checkbook. Check. Check. You can use checks to buy things. Look.
Hi.
Class, in Russia or in Saudi Arabia or in Brazil, are checks common? In America, I don't see them used a lot. Are checks common in your country? I mean, a long time ago, they were common, but now nobody uses checks. Neither do I.
Yeah, this
some people use it.
Does the stores like Walmart or something else, they accept checks?
They do.
Right now, accept, right?
They do.
Whoa.
But they're just not common.
Whoa.
Some stores don't and some stores do. The problem with checks, you know, if you have a store and I'm your customer and I write a check to buy something, it's possible there's not any money in my checking account or there's not enough money. In that situation, you, Andre, you will have a loss because normally the bank will charge you a fee. They'll charge me a fee and you a fee. So some businesses do not want to accept checks because it takes a long time to take out the money. Understand?
Mm-hmm. Yes. And what about if I don't have I don't have enough money on my checking account, but I would like to buy something, and I give this check to the store. What will happen?
Okay, so the bank may pay me, the bank may pay the store, but there will be a penalty and you will need to pay the penalty.
Okay, got it.
You understand? Like, yes. 25, it's a big penalty. It's $25 or more. I have never been in that situation because that is a very bad situation. But normally there's a big penalty. It's the same in Russia, right, or no?
Well, I live in Ukraine and checks. We don't have any checks like this.
At all? Zero?
Yeah.
Okay. In Russia, you do in use Russia, checks.
No.
Never.
No.
Never.
Okay. No one know about checks.
In Brazil, they accept checks, but they're not common, right?
Not common, but when I buy house, the bank sends one check for buy a house.
Okay.
No common. No, only for buy.
I don't like checks because it takes a long time to write. I need to be fast. I mean, that's my opinion. Asma, in Saudi Arabia, are checks common or not really?
Yeah, we have, but not all the people use, some people.
Thank you. So similar to America.
Did you find what you were looking for?
I did. Thank you.
Your total is $57.92.
On this line, you write the date, November 17th, 2003.
Class, I think In your country, you write the date differently than the United States, right?
Yes. You're right.
Yes.
The first is a day, then is the month.
Then year.
Okay. So in relation to the video, it's month, day, year. Mm-hmm. Class, tell me
month,
day, year.
Year.
In relation to this video, look at the Zoom chat. I put it in there for you.
The date, November 17th, 2003. On this line, you write the amount of money you are paying. Write it in numbers. $57.92.
What is the name of this store?
This store is called Buffalo Shirt Company.
On this line, you write to whom you are giving the money. On this line, you write the amount of money you are paying. Write it in words. $57.92.
Class, do you have any questions about writing a check?
No.
So
everyone understands the video, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
You write the cents over 100. On this line, you sign your name.
Class, please say signature.
Signature.
On this line, you write what you are.
Class, say me memo.
Memo
is the purpose. Like, what are you buying?
Mm-hmm.
Memo is the purpose. What are you buying? Maybe groceries, maybe food, maybe clothes, maybe a house, maybe a car. Understand? What are you spending the money on? What's the purpose?
You're buying clothing.
Here you go.
May I see your ID, please? Thank you. Have a nice day.
You too.
That money will come out of her checking account.
When you put money into an account, that is called a deposit. When you take money out of an account, that is called a withdrawal.
Class, please tell me withdrawal.
Withdrawal.
If you deposit $500, then you can write checks for up to $500. You can only write checks for the money that you have in the bank. If you need cash, you can make a withdrawal with a teller or the ATM. You can only withdraw the amount of money that you have in the bank.
Please do.
Class, any questions about this video or about this topic, please?
No.
Okay, so I want to teach you two expressions that are commonly used in finance. Class, say with me, dough.
Dough.
Doll means money. Doll means money.
Doll means money.
Doll means money.
Very good. Anastasia, can you please read doll for me, please, and the example?
I need more dough to pay off my credit card bill.
Very good. So again, dough means money.
Dough means money.
Right. See, this is my $10 bill. This is my money. This is my dough. Understand?
Yeah.
Okay. Plus, have money to burn, that means you have a lot of money. It's an expression. Can you please read this for me, Zan, please, or Yulia?
Have money to burn, have a lot of money. Sarah's dad always gives her a big allowance, so she has money to burn.
Very good. Class, allowance, that's normally money you give your kids.
Mm-hmm.
For example, Elizabeth is 17 years old. Her mom and dad give her an allowance. That's giving her money for spending on food, clothes, or whatever. Anybody in this class, when you were young, did your parents give you an allowance or no?
Yes. No.
Okay. Any questions, please?
No.
No.
Andre, can you please read question number one for me?
The woman got a credit card because she...
Good. Number two, Elizabeth, please.
The woman didn't buy.
Number three, Asma, please.
The man says that's a problem with the credit card, is that?
Good. Very good. Next one, Zan, please. Zan, please, I can't hear you.
Sorry. The credit card limit the woman's about...
These are the listening questions. Sergi, can you read the last question, please?
Yeah, sure. The man suggests that the woman...
Good. Class, are there any words you don't understand? Please ask me. Are there any words you don't understand?
Suggests.
Suggest, you give advice or recommendation.
Okay.
For example, Danny is very fat. Alex suggests going to the gym every day. Sorry, it's an example. Danny is very fat. Alex suggests going to the gym every day. Do you see the example sentence?
Yes.
Are there any other words you don't understand, please? Ready for the listening?
Yes.
Center. Hi, sis. I just came over to drop off the DVDs you wanted, and... Hey, wow. Where did you get all this stuff?
I bought it. So what do you think of my new entertainment center? And the widescreen TV?
Bought it?
And my new DVD player. Here, let me show you my stereo.
Sorry.
You can really rock the house with this one.
But where did you get the dough to buy all this? You didn't borrow money from Mom and Dad again, did you?
Of course not. I got it with this.
This? Let me see that. Have you been using Dad's credit card again?
No, silly. It's mine. It's a student credit card.
A student credit card? How in the world did you get one of these?
I got an application in the mail.
Well, why did you get one in the first place?
Listen, times are changing, and having a credit card helps you build a credit rating, control spending, and even buy things that you can't pay with cash, like the plane ticket I got recently.
What plane ticket?
Oh yeah, my roommate and I are going to Hawaii over the school break, and of course I need some new clothes for that, so...
I don't want to hear it. How does having a student credit card control spending? It sounds like you've spent yourself into a hole. Anyway, student credit cards just lead to impulse spending, as I can see here. And the interest rates of student credit cards are usually sky high. And if you miss a payment, the rates, well, just jump.
The credit card has a credit limit.
Of $20,000?
No, not quite that high. Anyway.
I've heard enough.
Did I tell you we now get digital cable with over 100 channels?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and here's your birthday present, a new MP3 player.
Yeah. No, don't tell me. Charged on the credit card. Listen. Hey, I don't think having a student credit card is a bad idea, but this is ridiculous. And how in the world are you going to pay off your credit card bill?
With my birthday money? It's coming up in a week.
Hey, let's sit down and talk about how you're going to pay things back. And maybe we can come up with a budget that will help you get out of this mess. That's the least I can do.
Class, do you want me to repeat?
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Before I repeat, are there any words you don't understand, please?
Hi, sis. I just came over to drop off the DVDs you wanted, and... Hey, wow. Where did you get all this stuff?
I bought it. So what do you think of my new entertainment center? And the widescreen TV?
Bought it?
And my new DVD player. Here, let me show you my stereo. You can really rock the house with this one.
But where did you get the dough to buy all this? You didn't borrow money from Mom and Dad again, did you?
Of course not. I got it with this.
This? Let me see that. Have you been using Dad's credit card again?
No, silly. It's mine. It's a student credit card.
A student credit card? How in the world did you get one of these?
I got an application in the mail.
Well, why did you get one in the first place?
Listen, times are changing, and having a credit card helps you build a credit rating, control spending, and even buy things that you can't pay with cash, like the plane ticket I got recently.
What plane ticket?
Oh yeah, my roommate and I are going to Hawaii over the school break, and of course I need some new clothes for that, so...
I don't want to hear it. How does having a student credit card control spending? It sounds like you've spent yourself into a hole. Anyway, student credit cards just lead to impulse spending, as I can see here. And the interest rates of student credit cards are usually sky high. And if you miss a payment, the rates, well, just jump.
The credit card has a credit limit.
Of $20,000?
No, not quite that high. Anyway.
I've heard enough.
Did I tell you we now get digital cable with over 100 channels?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and here's your birthday present, a new MP3 player.
Yeah. No, don't tell me. Charged on the credit card. Listen. Hey, I don't think having a student credit card is a bad idea, but this is ridiculous. And how in the world are you going to pay off your credit card bill?
With my birthday money? It's coming up in a week.
Hey, let's sit down and talk about how you're going to pay things back. And maybe we can come up with a budget that will help you get out of this mess. That's the least I can do.
Repeat again or no? Repeat or no?
No.
No.
No. Okay, the woman got a credit card because she
want to buy.
She also got credit
rating.
Very good. Yeah. Class, credit rating is the same credit score. Good job. The woman didn't buy
a stereo.
Digital camera.
Digital camera.
Digital camera. Good. The man says that a problem with credit cards is that
interest rates are very often very high.
Good, very good. Very good.
I like the
credit limit on
12,000.
20,000.
20.
18,000.
Yeah, 18. Well, she's not say like correctly amount, but it's 80, right? Yeah, okay.
18.
18,000.
Good. The man suggests that the woman
come up with a financial management plan.
Good, good, good. Class, any questions, please?
No.
No.
Class, one thing I did not explain well. So frugal means you are careful with how much money you spend. Okay. So frugal means you are careful with how much money you spend. Thrifty. Thrifty, it has the same meaning. You are careful with how much money you spend. For example, Anastasia is thrifty with money, or Anastasia is frugal with money. Okay, this means Anastasia does not spend a lot of money, okay? Does everyone understand frugal and thrifty are the same? I did yeah. not explain that well. Any questions, please?
No.
No questions?
No.
No.
We'll keep this quick. We're making breakfast without compromises your reality. Lunch.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Probably gonna start a fight. Don't just walk in the right. Hey, baby, come on. I love you endlessly. And you want to come for me. So now it's time to leave. Hey, baby, alone. I know that I can't take no more. It ain't no love. I wanna see you out that door, baby. Bye, bye, bye. Bye. Tomorrow's the test, okay? Bye-bye.
Bye.